really my honor to introduce, for the first time ever at PAX, the director of Kojima Productions and the creator of the Metal Gear Solid franchise. Everyone, here he is, all the way right off the plane from Japan where he had the event just a couple days ago, Mr. Hideo Kojima.
So this is going back about 25 years, and you know, back then I wanted to do something different, something new. So all the games back then, you know, were mostly about attacking the enemies, but I wanted to look at it from a different angle and try to maybe do something where you approach the enemy without having to attack them, go in and sneak in. So I wanted to try something a little bit different, and that's where the idea came from. And honestly, I didn't think it would continue for 25 years, so it's kind of a shock to me actually that I'm still doing it now.
Snake obviously is an iconic character. Sounds like we may be seeing him in Ground Zeroes, so we'll get to that. But you know, I think there's always been this link between Snake and the idea of Snake Plissken from Escape from New York. When you were creating this character, was that the inspiration? I mean, you know, at the time you seemed to want to have an American character in this game, not a Japanese character, and for, you know, a Japanese creator, that was certainly bold. Back in the day to do that. Do you remember why you did that?
So first of all, I just want to make it clear that, you know, I didn't make Snake because I saw Escape from New York. So I am a big Carpenter's fan, so, you know, I love his movies, and, you know, that's why I put a little bit of an homage in there, but that's not not where the original concept came from.
まず主人公は、まあ、特殊部隊なので本名は明かさないのでコードネームが必要です。
So of course, you know, the main character is in a special forces unit, so he needed a first name, code name, right?
なんであのスコーピオンでもコブラでもスネークでも何でもよかったんですけども、やっぱり潜入するということはその痕跡を残さずに行く動物ということで、まあ、ヘビみたいな、ヘビっていうのは草木を倒さないで進んでいくので、それでスネークとつけました。
So of course, you know, he needed a code name, you know, cobra, scorpion, or a spider, anything like that could have worked. But I felt that the idea of snake was really the best to express this feeling of, you know, sneaking around things and moving undetected.
で、あの、僕が、まあ、なぜアメリカ人を主人公にしているかと思いますけれども、まあ、世界中の文化に影響を受けて物語を作り出したので、自分が書いた子供の頃の小説とかも全部日本が舞台になっちゃう一個もないです。
So, you know, as far as why the character is not Japanese, you know, I wanted to have this grand scale to things, and, you know, all the things that I was influenced by, like novels and things when I was a kid, most of them didn't take place in Japan.
なんで、あの、ゲームに関してもスナッチャーぐらいですね、まあ、未来の工業ですけども、他は、アメリカを舞台にして、スケールの大きい話を作りたいので、アメリカを舞台でアメリカ人の主人公というふうになっています。
So, you know, most of my games, you know, Snatcher being the exception since it's a futuristic sci-fi game. The remainder of the games, however, you know, are primarily set in the United States, with the main character who's American.
Yes. Alright, so you did, you know, obviously the creation of Metal Gear was, you know, so important, I think, to your career. Tell us about Snake as a character, your relationship with Ishikawa, building this character. Did he always look the same? I mean, did you experiment with early sketches, other ideas for him? I mean, so you talked about his name, obviously just being a snake sneaking around. How did you create this character?
ですね、まずあのキャラクターの設定を、徹底的にします。子供の頃どこで生まれて何をして現在に至る、あるいはその未来のお話で語るその先のことまでをこう細かく設定をしていきます。そしてどんなセリフを言うとかも。
So first of all, the way I approach creating a character is I think about the character's past, his history, where he was born, and try to, you know, outline his life and then build upon that, think about, you know, what kind of things would he say and what would this character do. Then I give that concept to Shinkawa-san and then we discuss it, you know, throw ideas back and forth about this character concept.
ですけど、しんちゃんはですね、たまに僕の言うこと聞かないんで、全然違う男のキャラクターの女の子にしてきたりするのも非常に面白くて、それで採用されるキャラクターも多いです。
Yeah, so, you know, the thing is, you know, Shinkawa-san has very unique ideas, and, you know, he doesn't always just listen to what I tell him. So, you know, he comes up with a lot of cool, unique ideas that, you know, come about as a result of this discussion process.
最初のスネークはやっぱり 3D じゃなかった。スプライトがオブジェクトだったので、あんまりその、風貌とかキャラクター性を、に注力せず、それは表現力が乏しかったので、そこはあやふやなままスタートしたんですけども、プレイステーションになってからやっぱりそういうわけにいかないんで、ちょっと細かく仕草とか動きとか、カラーリングとかっていうのも、まあ、進化の2人で、ね、考えながら作りました。
Of course, you know, Snake as a character has his roots from the era of 2D games, so at that time, you know, there were limits to what we could express. So at the beginning, he's a pretty ambiguous character, you know, he didn't talk very much, he didn't have a lot of personality, but, you know, of course, once it evolved to the PlayStation era, you know, that wouldn't do, so that's when I really started to talk with Shinkawa-san about, you know, applying different kind of colors to the character and different, you know, very specific details.
Snake is, あくまでも Snake って暗号名なので、本当、本名は皆さんあるので、まあ、それ以上のことはゲーム中で言わないようにしています。
Yeah, so, you know, the other thing is, you know, Snake is the character in the game, that's the code name, but, you know, really, Snake is you, so, you know, that's another thing that plays into the design as well.
Character we all love, we're glad he might, it seems like he's back, right?
Yeah.
Characters, you know, Big Boss, Ocelot, you know, those types of characters, people love them, and I think it would be interesting some of the origin stories behind some of those characters. What was your creative process? I mean, you know, thinking about the characters that were around Snake in this world.
セルットに関しては日本でいうとマカロニウエスタン、こっちでいうとスパゲッティウエスタンっていう僕西部劇大好きだったんで、そのキャラクターを出したいということで、作ったのがオセロットです。
So as far as Ocelot is concerned in particular, you know, I'm a big fan of spaghetti westerns and I want to have a character like that in my games, since that's where the idea for Ocelot came from.
でビッグボスとかに関してはそのメタルギアっていうのはその次の世代に何を伝えるかっていうテーマなんですけども、要は自分が、両親とかを超えていくという、自分が前の世代を超えていく、前の世代を超えながら次の世代を紡いでいくっていうストーリーなんで、そのためには非常に重要な、キャラクターとして、スネークの親としてのビッグボスを出しました。
As far as Big Boss is concerned, you know, one of the overall themes of the Metal Gear series is having, you know, the main character surpass his predecessors, surpass the people who came before him, and you know, really usher in a new generation. So in that sense, Metal Gear Solid 3 is really a key chapter in the series, and Big Boss is a very key character because he's basically like, you know, Snake's father. So that's where I really want to put a lot of detail into that character.
There's obviously another character we should talk about, which is Raiden, his sort of involvement across the series. We all remember that surprise in Metal Gear Solid 2, which we weren't expecting. Well, get the secret, everyone knows playing it. He's going to make his debut in his own game, which you know, you announced a few years ago at E3, and it's evolved into Metal Gear Rising of Vengeance, as we talked about MGS last year. Tell us about the creation of this character. I think he was, you know, very, very controversial, obviously, when he was first introduced.
Raiden, I like it.
So first of all, how many people here like Raiden? So for people who jump in at Metal Gear Solid 2, you know, from their perspective, Snake is already like a big boss type of character. But you know, as I mentioned earlier, there's that theme about, you know, exceeding your predecessors. From that perspective, Raiden is like the original Snake in the original Metal Gear. You know, he's the guy who has to surpass
でもう一つはその、スネークというのがこう神格化された中で、プレイヤーが操作するのではなくてもっとキャラクターを作りたかったんで、ライデンという新しいキャラクターを動かしながら客観的にスネークを見ることでさらに英雄度を増すというかそういう作り方を MGS2 でやりました、結果的には不評だったんですけどね、
はい。And so, you know, another thing is, you know, Snake is kind of like this legendary hero, and so I want to build upon that. And rather than have the player play as this legend, you know, it's more effective to have someone else looking at him and seeing him as a separate character, and it's this really cool character that helps you on the side. So that's why I wanted to come up with this new character, Raiden, as the main player character. That was the original concept. In the end, maybe it didn't work out so well. Some people didn't really like him, but that's where the concept came from.